Hi guys, and welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we're going to talk about Solana, which is one of the fastest growing and largest blockchains anywhere in the cryptocurrency market. Obviously, nothing I talk about on this channel is financial advice, so always go away and do your own research before investing any of your money. Without further ado, let's jump into today's video. Okay guys, so jumping across to the Solana website, which as always is linked down below in the description, so make sure you go and check it out after this video if you want to learn more about the project. You can see that Solana is a powerful tool for developers and that is very fast for everyone. If you've been in crypto for a little bit, then you probably have heard of Ethereum, and Solana does something a little bit similar to Ethereum, but many think that it's a superior product because it's that much faster and significantly cheaper because it operates in a slightly different way from Ethereum. It's basically a decentralized blockchain that allows for various smart contracts, etc., to be produced and linked onto the blockchain. Now, unlike Ethereum, it's a little bit more difficult for developers, etc., to go and build dApps on the platform because they have to basically code them from scratch, whereas Ethereum and perhaps some others are a little bit easier to build on because of the way that they operate. However, this kind of more straightforward approach is actually what enables it to be a much more powerful and a much quicker system for those building the dApps on the platforms. There's obviously some negatives, but in my opinion, it is outweighed by the performance of this compared to what we see in others. You can see down below that the transaction speed per second is 1,265 transactions per second at the moment. It also has the ability to perhaps go significantly faster than that. It operates at around 30 times the speed of a Visa, which shows the opportunity that it has for being used in future use cases, as well as its blockchain operates significantly faster than anything else, creating a new block every 400 milliseconds. Compare that with Bitcoin, which takes up to 10 minutes to produce a block, and Ethereum up to around 10 seconds. This enables far faster transactions, as well as that to be much, much cheaper. Here you can see the total transactions been created so far, obviously being added to all the time, 76 billion there. And you can see the average cost per transaction is 0.00025 cents, which is insanely cheap when we compare that with the gas fees, etc., that you expect from Ethereum. Here you can see that Solana is the fastest growing blockchain in the world and has basically got into projects like decentralized finance, NFTs, and Web3. And if you've had any interest in NFTs and things in the past, many of those originally started out on the Ethereum blockchain, and the problem with that is that the gas fees can be super high. So maybe you want to buy an NFT that's around $100. You could perhaps even end up having gas fees that are higher than the actual item you're trying to buy, particularly when the markets are booming, not really booming at the moment, but when they sort of do further down the line. It can be insanely expensive to be using other blockchains for your NFT projects, which is why I think that the future of NFTs is in blockchains like Solana. There's various Solana-based NFT projects that you can go and invest in, which makes them much easier and cheaper to get involved in. In terms of sort of scalability of Solana, Solana is actually limited at the moment only by the technology that exists in the world. And what I mean by that is in terms of the speed of processes, etc., which is why they believe that in every 2 years that Solana will then become double the speed that it is currently, making it one of the most exciting projects around. You can see that they integrate once and you never have to worry about scaling again. Solana ensures composability between ecosystem projects by maintaining a single global state as the network scales. Never deal with the fragmented layer 2 system or sharded chains. If you come up to the developers tab here, you can see that there's lots of different features in order to find what you're looking for. And if you look on the left hand side, we can see NFTs, we've got DeFi, gaming, payments, and DAOs. So just for example, looking into NFTs, you can see the mint, sell, and trade NFTs at scale. And all you need to do is click on get started, and then you can go about building your NFT projects, and it will talk you through how all of that works. You can see that the Solana NFT market at the moment is around $970 million, with the average mint cost being $1.50 and 5.7 million NFTs. You can see in terms of the benefits I already talked about, you know, it's all about the speed, the cost obviously being much cheaper. So overall, Solana's a pretty fantastic platform which makes it really exciting. And if you're interested in NFTs and stuff like that, then make sure you subscribe to this channel because we often talk about NFTs. And if you want to learn more about creating NFT projects, then maybe come across to the Solana website link down below and you can find out more about that here. Now, another cool thing, and I think is going to be huge coming up later this year. Obviously, we saw the explosion of GameFi last year, which is basically linking gaming and decentralized finance together. And as the development of Web3, etc. comes in, you can see again another use case for Solana, which is really, really exciting. With low fees, fast speeds, and enabling gaming to take place in Web3 environments super fast, super cheap, and super seamless. If you come down below, you can see some of the games that have already been created on Solana platforms, so there's lots of exciting things to be seen here. You can see the decentralized payments at scale. A lot of the problems people have talked about in cryptocurrency is whether or not it can replace current systems, obviously in terms of speeds of transactions and things. Bitcoin initially was maybe being seen as a potential for a payment solution, but obviously we talked about the speed, which obviously creates a big problem because it can't handle enough transactions in the required time because of the way that it works. But anyone in the Solana network can basically act as a validator, making it very quick, very cheap, and very easy to be able to process all of the different transactions happening at one time. So it offers the opportunity for online payments, etc., in-store payments, and much, much more. And as I've already mentioned, maybe can be a little bit more difficult in terms of the setup because it requires sort of raw coding to be done without kind of like a base, etc., to be able for developers to build upon. But ultimately, once implemented, it's going to be significantly cheaper and more efficient than many of the other products out there. By clicking on ecosystem, you can see that there's lots of other things available to check out over here. You've got various things like the Phantom wallet, which is pretty much like the MetaMask wallet, but for the Solana blockchain. Here you can see all the different trending projects and things coming up, as well as kind of different games. You've got DeFi projects, lending protocols, NFT marketplaces, Web3 apps, and much, much more. Loads of cool stuff to come and take a look at here. By coming across and looking at stuff that's popular, guys, you could also find yourself being able to find a good investment kind of early on. Right now, crypto market's a little bit quiet, a little bit slow, but that's when the best opportunity is there. So make sure you're coming across, finding these kind of new platforms, etc., that could have a really good potential, because as soon as that crypto market starts to move again, I guarantee that the smaller altcoins are going to be where the biggest returns are found. Obviously, it's more risky investing in the smaller coins than it is in perhaps the big, like Solanas, Bitcoins, etc. But the returns obviously have far more potential to be much bigger. Obviously, a higher risk, higher reward kind of theory goes along with crypto. Clicking on the Twitter page, guys, you can see 1.8 million followers. Obviously, a very well-established large project, but still with loads of cool stuff coming up. You've got all the collaborations and various other things going on here, as well as information on the future of the platform. So make sure you come across and check out their Twitter, because there's lots of information that you can find out. And as well, they have information on various events that you may well be able to get a chance to go and attend if it's in a city or something nearer to you. So in summary, Solana is one of the fastest and cheapest blockchains available in the cryptocurrency market right now. It's already changing the way that the NFT marketplaces, DeFi, GameFi, and much, much more are operating. And there's loads of potential for development of further things on the platform in the future. So if you're interested in investing or you're interested in developing on this platform, then make sure you head over to the Solana website, which is linked down below in the description. Guys, if you got any value out of today's video, then make sure you smash the thumbs up button. Thanks very much for doing that. Helps us out more than you know. And if you're new to the channel, then make sure you subscribe to be kept up to date with all of the latest happening in NFTs, crypto, Web3, and much, much more. Thanks very much for watching, guys, and I'll see you soon with another video. Bye-bye.